So many of you, I would just like to share something which you would never have heard about the Art of Living Foundation. How many of you have heard about the Art of Living Foundation or Gurudev Shishu Ravishankar? I think everybody. So you know, in 1982 we started, and we started, Gurudev Shishu Ravishankar started it in a, started with a small school, and the school was in his own house. And you know how many children were there in his own house for the 2 BHK house? 175 children. So 175 children were studying from there, and we started the school. And small children, we are going to study. We used to catch hold of those children and come. You know, he's done that. To catch hold from the villages just to give them education. Making sure that we at least get education in the villages of Bangalore, nearby Bangalore. And post this, there was help provided from every corner that came. So one man said that, you know, he is leaving for the US and he wants to give his own house for the school. So the school suddenly shifted into an independent house. Then one farmer whose child was studying there said that, you know, I have had a bumper crop. Why don't I come and give you the bumper crop for the meals that you provide? And like this, there was help from all quarters. So what started as a medium of education became a mass movement across the world. Today, the Art of Living Foundation is in 155 countries. And in most colleges of India, I'm sure you would have also, some of you would have done the courses also. And that's where our whole program started. Now, to do such a thing would not have been easy. I'm sure you would agree to that. It is a mass movement and it is a voluntary based organization and it is sustainable and it is replicable. Now if you want to do something beyond your comfort zone, then only entrepreneurship comes into your life, isn't it? If you want to do only your comfort zone, that's called a job. But beyond your comfort zone, there is something called as risk. There is something called as challenges, and only the spirit has the ability to take a challenge or a risk. So what I call it as a spiritual space. If you want to take a risk, if you want to take some challenges, then you need to dive into your spiritual space. Now what is spirituality for that? If you notice, where does enthusiasm come from? How do you feel on a Monday morning? How do you feel on a Friday, Saturday evening? Come on, how do you feel? How do you feel on a Monday morning? How do you feel in a lecture at 2 o'clock? So where does enthusiasm come from? Where does energy come from? Where does, you know, this friendliness come from? Where does teamwork come from? Where does love come from? There is a spiritual space. Can enthusiasm be increased? If I tell you, you have to study, and if I tell you, you have to go and play football. Can there be a difference? Can enthusiasm be increased? Yes. Can energy inside your system be increased? Energy can be increased. And that is called the spiritual space. Now, the other thing is, it doesn't work. You know, with people, it doesn't work with motivation. It works with inspiration. Motivation, if you're going to give them more discounts, if you're going to raise their salaries, if you're going to give them more bargains, it will die. Because with motivation, you have to keep increasing the appetite. Your appetite grows bigger and bigger in motivation. But in inspiration, everybody is connected to you. So while organizations think only about themselves as an organization, the Art of Living Foundation started working on people base. So we are actually in India, we are registered as Vyakti Vikas Kendra. We are not registered as Art of Living. One person, you provide peace, skill and innovation to one person, I tell you, slowly, slowly the society will grow and become peaceful and innovative. So peace at the level of one person can be peace at the level of the whole society. And similarly does entrepreneurship work. In your system, in your college, in your in your classroom, if I ask you how many people do you have friends? Like you can call them friends. Yeah, these are my friends. Wow, this is my group of friends. If you have a classroom of 50 people, how many would be friends? I say that episode, if it increases to 20, 40, 50, and right from childhood, we need to train our children to make more and more friends. I usually ask this question to all 6, 7 year old, how many friends do you have? They usually name 3 or 4. They can't go beyond that. And this attitude of friendliness, this attitude of teamwork, this attitude of sustainability being together can make you an entrepreneur beyond compare. Now for example, let me ask you one thing. Imagine if you are playing a relay race. Okay, so now you are the first one to run. You are the first one to run, you ran your 200 meters and now you have just handed over the baton to the second one. Now what do you do? What would you do at that time? Do you go for a coffee break? Do you go for a restroom break? What do you do? Encourage the other person then? What would you do at this moment when the other person is running? Would you say, okay, let me just take a small chit chat and come? No, you would be as attentive in that game as much as you ran. So there was full action from your side, but right now you are there and you are peaceful but totally attentive with this whole group. And you do the same thing with the third person, you do the same thing with the fourth person. Agree? You are just standing there because the race is dependent. It is dependent on all four, and if all four perform better, then you win. And this is the principle of art of living also. This is the principle as moving from arrogance to pride in everybody's winning. Moving from, you know, self-centeredness to group work, to teamwork. Moving from just being yourself and independent to moving towards interdependence. And this is the way, if this attitude you have of belongingness for everyone and everyone winning the race, and you intersphere it with some commerce. I know the question is, will this help me to make the company profitable? I tell you, absolutely. Focusing on individuals and making them powerful can make the company powerful. Focusing only on your organization cannot happen that way. So both are required. Now the third aspect which is required, if I ask you, if you have a laptop in front of you, you haven't worked on Sunday, you come back to your desk, your office space on Monday, and you see there is some dust on the laptop. What would you do? Would you clean it?
Yes.
Yes, no?
Yes.
Great. Well, there's some dust on the table also. Would you clean that?
Yes.
There is some dust on the floor also. And the lady who's coming to clean it has not come. Would you clean that?
No.
Would you clean that?
No.
So where do you draw a line? Where is your line? If you can extend the line of care, if you can extend the line of belongingness, if you can extend the line of teamwork and intersphere it with commerce, this is entrepreneurship. Entrepreneurship doesn't mean only I win. It means, you know, especially if you are in Mumbai and you go to this Muhammad Ali Road, if you go to Lohar Chawal, if you go to these places, have you noticed there are group of shops with the same thing? Like if there is a hardware shop, there will be 100 hardware shops. Have you seen this?
Yeah.
If there are, if there are light shops, there will be 100 light shops together. And surprisingly, all of them do good in that area. In that sphere, all of them do good. I remember this episode, I had gone to Dakshineshwar temple in Calcutta. And you know, as soon as you enter this temple, surprisingly, all of them will, you know, all these shopkeepers will say, okay, come and buy prasad from me, come and buy prasad. And almost 100 of them, imagine 100 of them pouncing on you, come and buy prasad from me, come and buy prasad from, you know, this shop. I just decided to select all of them, like literally arrogant, you could see like there's lot of competition. And then when I bought prasad from one, so I asked this guy, do you earn enough that, you know, So because so many of them are competing against each other, almost 100 of them, he said, no, no, we are best friends. We just played this part of the role so properly, but you will surprisingly see we all sit and eat together. So there is this four abilities which can help any one of you who wants to become an entrepreneur and take it forward. That is how we have learned from the Art of Living, which is such a big organization today, operating on volunteers and reached to 155 countries. The first is the spiritual space. You need to know how to increase the enthusiasm and sustain it, because after some time, you will notice that it is decreasing, decreasing and decreasing. Has it happened to you?
Yes.
In most cases it happens. You come in first year, you decide, I'm going to talk. But fourth year, there is nothing called like that. Yeah? Then second, and how to increase that spiritual space is by meditation, is by diving deep within. You know, it's like an arrow. If you want to hit it at the right spot, you have to pull the string as much back. The string constitutes your mind. The deeper your mind starts having joy, happiness from yourself, from within, that's the level of enthusiasm you can get. And that's why we have the, you know, here when you enter IIT, surprisingly it's called Tantra Gyan. So Tantra surprisingly means techniques. So you need to have techniques to relax your mind also. Do you have that? Do you have that? Can you relax your mind at will? Whenever you want to, now this person has come in front of you, whom you don't like, and he happens to be your wingmate, mostly it's like that, he comes in front of you, what do you think? Let me just push him from the person. It will be service to humanity. Let me just chop him like tomatoes. It will be service to humanity. And every time he comes in front of you, these emotions of dislike, anger, disgust rise in you. So this person is just a postman for those emotions of dislike, distrust already sitting inside you. How can you operate to the emotions than the person? Usually we operate through the person. We are here to change people. Instead, can it be possible to change yourself so that the emotions can just relax? Is there a possibility? Yes. And this is called a technique. A technique is when you become powerful than the people around you, and you can make a change and influence people. So second one is finding ways to relax. Finding ways. Now relaxation, when you talk about in institutions, I know what you understand. When you say relaxation, you mostly in institutions people understand dhoti bottle chal jayega. Not at all. Relaxation at will is some technique which you need to learn in life. And then how to sustain and replicate what you have made. If you have made some product, how to replicate this? And this, surprisingly, inspiration has become replicable in the Art of Living scenario. Gurudev started it, and today we have 20,000 teachers across 155 countries. You know, I happen to be in Cordoba, the Argentinian tip, down South Pole. And there also if you go, people are doing pranayam. And in a big number, I happen to be in Minsk, almost the North Pole of Russia. And there also people are doing pranayam and meditation. So it has been replicated, and they don't, both of these countries don't understand English. Both of these countries have no connection with Hindi or India for that matter. But it has become replicable in all these countries. So sustainability, how to do sustainability. You know, the best poster of spirituality and entrepreneurship would be Narayana and Lakshmi together. Have you seen Narayana and Lakshmi together? Vishnu and Lakshmi, have you seen together the poster? Vishnu is nicely sleeping on a serpent in the ocean, and Lakshmi is sitting at his feet. You know, sometimes they extrapolated with some grapes and all that. But that means that Vishnu is the lord of spirituality. He is the boss of spirituality. He is the captain. He knows when to and how to use the spiritual space and how to create it. Now he's sleeping on a serpent, which means, you know, the snake is a symbol of awareness, alertness. So you have to keep a vigil on your own mind. Are you watching your mind? Sometimes, are you watching your mind? What does it say? Or is the mind just feeding you? Are you over your mind, or is your mind over you? So keeping a kind of a vigil on your mind, keeping aware what is happening in my mind. The moment you are aware, I tell you, your 90% of your problems are solved. But if you are not aware, it starts with, I don't like this person, I don't dislike this, and it ends into hatred. So, now, sleeping on a serpent, but what does the ocean indicate? The ocean indicates abundance. Like, I have it too much. I have it. It's there with me. It's called anant. Having the power of abundance and santosh, contentment. And if you have these things and the spiritual space, Lakshmi, the goddess of wealth, is going to just follow you wherever you are. So here in India, spirituality is not averse to being rich. In fact, if you are spiritual and you are the right person, wealth should be with you. That's what the gods and goddesses mean. If you look at Indian gods and goddesses, they are bedazzled with wealth. Like there, if you look at their earrings, you look at their hairdos, you look at their tattoos, Shiva has, they have like spent too much money on their makeup. Look that. And that would be a great thing, that creating spirituality and awareness and a mind which has the ability to rest at will, I tell you, the goddess of wealth will follow you. It is not possible. That's the indication. And of course, innovation, teamwork, care are all attributes of a relaxed mind. So that's why I named my talk as iPod, which means that having total inner peace and full outer dynamism. Inner peace does not mean going and sleeping, which most of us are professionals at. I remember when I was in college in first year, I could do it at 20 hours a day. So inner peace also means the alertness, awareness, and then resting in it. And then seeing life from this perspective, as if you have given the baton to somebody else, and his will is your will too. Then you are free of jealousy, you are free of greed. And that is the message that I wanted to give to all of you today. And best wishes to all of you, and thanks to the great organizing by this team of e-summit and Virupaksh, Aman, and everybody. Thank you so much.